Hi there, Facebook. I'm Rebecca Keller of Bex Artworks AVL here in beautiful Asheville, North Carolina. And I want to thank you so much for joining me today. This is my first time on Facebook Live, so I have no idea how this is going to go. That's part of the first stuff. The first thing that I'm doing is I'm going to be doing a landscape, actually using brushes and everything with paint, which is a first for me, other than like fabric painting years ago. I do paint, but I actually do what's called acrylic pour painting. So you take the different colors of paint and you put them, you know, in a cup or through a colander or different ways of manipulating it, and then you pour it onto the canvas. And it's very freeing because it sort of does its own thing. You don't really have to worry about trying to make a foot look like a foot. It's just abstract. It's going to do what it's going to do. So the scary and fun thing that we're going to do today is I'm actually going to try and do a landscape painting that actually looks like something. So I'm excited about it. I'm a little nervous. So we'll see how this goes. I can't promise that this will be completely PG-13 because we'll just see what happens. But I have my cheat sheet over here. I'm going to turn it around and just set the... What started me on this path of trying a landscape, actually, is I watched a video on Amazon Prime. This guy, Frank Clark, hilarious Irish painter guy. And the way he explained it, it was very simple and just kept it very straightforward, you know, simple colors, and it's just a pretty little mountainy watercolor, I mean, waterfront sort of scene. And that's what I'm going to try and do today. So, with that being said, I'm actually going to switch it around so hopefully you can see the canvas. Oops, that's a little dirty. So hold on. Try not to knock stuff over. And in just a sec, and I will come and double check that you can see. Or if my brave cameraman, my wonderful husband, can give it a look-see. Can you see that? Is that okay? Or I'll let you. Got it? Look like, bump up the light a little bit. Like that, we're learning. That's what it's all about. Whether you're doing art or you're doing video. Thank you, baby. It's all about learning, trying new things. So, we will see what we will see. I have, thank you. Yes, because I'm definitely going to need water. All right, so we are using the Arteza brand paints. These are the same paints that I use for the acrylic pour painting. They are all water-based as opposed to oil-based. So the great thing about them is if and when you do make a mess, it's pretty easy to clean up. And also they dry really quickly, which was one of the things that Frank pointed out about being able to do this paint as a landscape is instead of having to do part of it and then wait like an oil for it to dry, you can actually sort of move ahead fairly rapidly. So that's kind of nice too. So we have titanium white and we're doing ultramarine blue. And I'm supposed to be using raw sienna, but actually I don't have raw sienna. So I'm going to try burnt sienna, which is a little darker, and you know, it's my landscape, so it's a, you know, it was a dry summer. They'll have a little bit of a browner tint, possibly, than they might normally. As a backup, if I do feel the need to make it more golden, which is more the color of the raw sienna, I do have some yellow ochre that I can always bring that in if I want more of a little golden sort of look. So, you know what? That's one of the big reasons that I've been trying to get into art. Well, one of the things that held me back actually from doing art, which I wanted to do for a very long time, was sort of the worry about being, you know, everything's got to be perfect. It's got to look just like, you know, almost like photography. That what I see in my mind's eye, I want to see on the canvas. And I could never get that to happen. So I just never even tried. I let that hold me back, but I decided I'm not going to do that. gonna try it. Like I said, started with the abstract, which is very nice, and now I've decided to try this. So I thank you for coming on this journey with me. So Frank has a great mnemonic way of remembering sort of like the order in which to go to try and do the painting, and it's you do the horizon, then sky, then the middle ground, and then the foreground. So HSMF, or as he says, H, because he's Irish. And hilarious, I highly recommend, if you have Amazon Prime, go look for Intro to Acrylic Painting. So HSMF, have some more fun. And that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna start with our, I have my cheat sheets on my pad for here. We're gonna start with our smallest brush, which is just in water. Again, it's not like oils where you have to use like paint thinner and all that stuff. So, all right, time for the big step. We're gonna put paint on the canvas. So I've got my ultramarine blue. And so for horizon, you don't wanna do it splitting in the middle. I'm sorry, that's clicking sound you hear is my dog in the kitchen. Boudreaux, get out of the kitchen. So I'm going to go about a third up from the bottom and do the line. You can use a straight edge if you want to, or we're just gonna wing it. So, I'm so nervous, I gotta be honest. All right, we're gonna go, hey buddy, hey, you're here to help mama? Oh, thank you buddy. All right, so Boudreaux's giving me support, we're gonna do it. Okay, we've put paint on our canvas. We have our horizon. Whew, that is scary. All right, and we're gonna leave that. We're just gonna leave it, because that's just our start. Okay, so next we're going to put in our sky. Buddy, I do not have food. I know that's what you think is going on, but it's just paint here, smell the brush. It's just water, you can't eat it. Go lay down, please. Go lay down. I had to use the mama voice. All right, so for our sky, he says it is about 75% white and 25% of the sienna. So I'm going to do a little bit of the yellow ochre, actually, for our sky, because we want sort of, you know, that golden, nice golden glow you get in the sky. And he's like, don't mix the paint up too much, just keep it kind of on the brush, so you get a little color variation. And we're just going to fill this top section until we get about an inch from the horizon. And that's gonna be our base coat on our sky. So, all right, we're going for it. And one of the things that he talks about is just not be stingy with your paint. You know, it's like, make sure you get a good amount of paint on your brush, and because if you scrub too much, which I feel like I'm starting to do, you're going to get mud. As colors blend together, they have a tendency, that's one word, to gray each other out, especially if they're in certain positions on the color wheel together. And this is true in acrylic flow painting, pour painting, as it is in any kind of, you know, time that you're using your paints. One more. And again, with the acrylic flow painting, we try and make sure to give plenty of paint on the canvas, because that helps it flow, and that's how you get, you know, your motion is by going in and, If it's just dragging, then it's just, he says, it's like if you're painting the garage door, you gotta have plenty of paint, or you're just gonna sit there and scrub things, and you don't wanna overwork it. My sky's gonna be a little more afternoon-y than maybe his was, but that's okay, because it's my sky. And we're just gonna go with it. Alright, so we've got sort of our undercoat of golden goodness. Okay, this is the other thing. It's hard to start and it's hard to stop. You want to do stuff, so we're gonna stop. So now we're gonna come back with some of the blue. And he had this marvelous word. He said we're going to scrumble. We're gonna scrumble the blue. So we're just gonna load the brush with the ultramarine blue and just sort of scrub in. Sort of making this, you know, car clouds, nothing too obvious or very free and easy. Give us some variation on our sky. Like I said, Frank is just a hoot and a holler to watch, and I highly recommend you checking him out. He does a series on watercolors. I think he does one on oils as well. I know he's got one on seascapes. This is his intro one. It's about doing the acrylic painting. So, sort of our interesting. And again, don't want to overwork it because we don't want to get the mud. So it's one of the biggest things that people unfortunately have an issue with, working it until it gets muddy. So to finish up the sky, we're going to just lightly sort of drag the brush across to get it, just really soften it. Put a little water on the brush. Lightly softening, like there's a wind blowing across the sky, and you know, you get that nice whispering sort of effect. Maybe a little more. The other thing that's cool with Frank is he's Irish, like me. My family is, on my mother's side, is very Irish. There are Fitzgeralds, there are like 900 cousins, yeah. So, and he's also left-handed, which I think is pretty cool. Although he holds his brush a little differently from me, but I think it's kind of cool. So, we're gonna be fine with it. Like I said, I'm trying not to be overcritical. And one thing he recommends is just keep doing basically the same painting over and over again. You know, trying different things, different mixes, you know, to get your hand at it. Don't, you know, don't let it stress you out. So, I think we are good with this. So that's our sky. A little cloudy. We'll see how it turns out. All right. The other thing says, keep your brushes in the water. It's like, if you learn nothing else, or to automatically put your brushes back in the water. Because otherwise they dry out and, you know, not good. Alright, so we're going to do mountains in our background. And so he says, well, this is actually our middle. So if we don't S, remember. Sky, horizon, sky, middle, and then foreground. So we've done our half. Some, now it's time for more and then five. So we are going to, instead of try and, you know, okay, picture a mountain, we're gonna do a mountain. No, so basically you're just gonna do an M, just wobbly. He said, you know, think about trying to draw an M the morning after you've had a fine night out at the pub. So he said like half blue and half sienna. Mix it too much. We're just gonna let it mix on the brush and just sort of squeeze it across, and again, we're gonna go for it. So all right, our first part of our mountain. Again, so this is how I'm going to load it on the brush. Okay, so we have our wobbly end. And so you just go back in and kind of fill in your M. Your mouth in. Paint. Again, we're not going to be, like I said, stingy with the paint. Don't be stingy with the paint. I said, mine is turning out much darker than his example. Again, like I said, I have the wrong sienna, but it's okay. Mountain's coming all kinds of colors, so we're going to just go with what we got. Play the cards that we have. I'm a little bit below my horizon, but you know what? I'm not going to worry about it. Like Tom said, so I'm not going to let it bother me tonight. Okay. Again, stop. okay, we have da-da-da. Alright, so, again, paintbrush back in the water. One of the things that he says is great about, again, the acrylic paints, instead of having, you know, what I was talking about earlier about having to wait for them to dry. Hair dryer. You can dry them. Right now, from my angle, I can see a little bit of sheen of wetness on the on the paint. So as it dries, it'll turn matte. If you've done makeup, you know the difference between matte and wet. So we're going to blow dry for just a minute and. So we get to that. Then that will let us go ahead and paint on top without, again, getting the mud. Already, I'm loving my sky. I'm really proud of my sky. My sky's turning out well. I think I have a little candid in here, but you know what? That'll know better for next time. And like he said, just plan on everybody getting a different version of this painting for Christmas. Like, congratulations, you get a painting, you get a painting, everybody gets a painting. Okay, so da, 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 da. Okay, so now we're switching to the medium brush. And we're going to do our the sort of front of this sort of riverfront that we're going to have because there should be water down here. So the sienna and the white. And again, I'm just kind of adding these together. There's always remember white is going to be the one you're going to use kind of the most. So we'll got a good size blob of white on there. So we're just going to see how this goes. Alright, I can tell that I have mixed it too much on the palette. Because I'm not getting nice a difference of colors like I had wanted. Because I found a myself being afraid of actually taking it just, but you know what, I'm going to chin it up. Because I think it's going to make it more interesting. Or not, or I'm actually going to make it more. Oh, Lord. Okay. Let's go back with some of the yellow ochre and white. Let's try that. See if that helps. So the advantage is I've seen what I'm trying to emulate, and you have not. So you can't tell how badly I'm messing this up, and that's okay. That's all right, because that's why you do a something like a landscape instead of, you know, like an imaginary space instead of something that somebody actually knows. Because then they can be like, well, that looks nothing like my grandma, you know. Like, oh, well, now I'm just getting crazy. Because now I'm just like trying to distract myself from the money that's going to take. But it's going to be fine. It's going to be fine. I have faith. Okay. Okay, so now we're going to do back with our big brush, and this is her. Just so. It's going to be our riverbank. I kind of feel like Dory, so just keep painting, 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 painting. So we're just going to keep painting. Just going to keep moving ahead and doing what Frank said and going for it. So we're going to use just the edge of the big brush where we're more doing, you know, flat on the others. We're just doing the edge on this to do our little riverbank. Oh, that's quite nice. A little bit watery, but hey, it's a riverbank, right? Okay. Seriously, though. Kind of like thinking about, you know, Bob Ross. We'll just add happy trees to just cover up anything that we got crazy on. So, and our riverbank. I kind of like my riverbank. I like this part. So I probably shouldn't go in and screw with it, huh? Probably should back away. Back away. Alright. So, now we're going to work on the river. The water that's going to be below that that riverbank. So, you would think, well, of course, we're going to use blue. You would be wrong. We're actually going to start with, again, like we do with the sky, sort of an undercoat of a golden-y kind of color. Just get some more white. That's not too bad. Again, using the white and the yellow ochre instead, since I don't have the rock sienna. A little bit of the burnt sienna, as you can see, jumping out. Burnt sienna goes a long way. It does not take much unless to take over. And again, I need more white. And just with this undercoat. Come back with the blue. I feel like, say, you've only got a couple of, really, four colors in total here, but because of how it blends together and everything, you get all these nuances, which is really kind of nice. Like I said, it should only be three colors, but again, we go with what we got. And then we're going to come back across. We'll mess around with the rubber band here. Looks pretty good. Alright, and again, time to blow dry. Do not blow dry away the... So I was just saying, do not blow dry away the palette paper that has my pink on it, because that'd be a mess. Okay. You have to kind of look away and then you come back to it to appreciate it. Hey, Bourgeois. Nobody. It is not. Mom's still doing her thing. Go lay down. Go lay down. Bourgeois. All right. So, now it's time for the foreground. Horizon, sky, middle. And then foreground, it's going to be in the front. And so this is one of the places where people have a tendency to kind of get out of control. It's where they want to start putting in like 9 million little flowers or ducks or whatever, you know, stuff that kind of just detract from the other. It's like, don't go crazy. Just, you know, again, for starting out, just start simple. So again, we're going back to our big brush. And we're going to be doing like some reeds. Grasses. So we're going to be doing the blue. About 75% blue and 25% of the sienna. So again, I'm going to keep it kind of mottled on the brush and then you're just going to pleased with this, that the way you're getting like that, some little stripes of blue and some that are a little more brown in terms of some variety. I'll make it look like uniform. And this is our foreground. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to sit here and do it. Again, it's that fear of perfectionism that you have to get past to just have fun with it and try things. Sorry. I let it go up. Up is nice because then you get like a spear. Okay, now I'm all over the water. All right, we're stop. Just stop. Put the brush down. Okay, we're putting the brush in. And some of them naked. I know I just said put the brush down, but that was for there, it wasn't for that. So I'm gonna do this white. It's no, I don't know. I feel like I can see too much canvas. Again, you know, that's something I can learn. The next one. Now, just I've completely made my. All right, it's just. Stop it. Put the brush on. Okay. It's so hard. It's so hard to just back away from it. I'm going to blow dry it just a little bit because so I want to kind of see how it's going to clear up. Finish it off. We got our water and the blue. We're gonna get very inky blue, like watercolor and blue. Very thinned out. And we just make a little V. And there's a bird. All right, that's it. That is it. That's all I'm doing with this. Is it great? Probably not. But I think it's pretty darn good for a first try. Like I said, I'm really happy with my sky. My sky turned out well. I think my water turned out well. Those are kind of good. They end up looking a little plaid at moments. But you know what? It's going to be fine. For not having the exact colors that I wanted, and for never having done this before, I'm going to say thumbs up, and I'm very happy about it, and I thank you all for coming, and I would turn the camera around, but I can't see myself, so I'll probably just show you my ear, so I'm going to say bye, and thank you so much for joining me, and I hope you enjoyed watching this, and more than that, I hope that you go out and go to Prime Video and find Frank and try it yourself. You know, if I can do this, anybody can do it. And that's what he says. Anybody can paint. And I truly believe that. And again, thank you so much for coming. And I'll see you next time. Thank you.